and became a foot doctor. I came to Crown Heights on Kingston Avenue and started work. I received a phone call that I should go do a house call for Mrs. Schneerson. I went there, treated her. She gave me tea and cake, and I left. The next day, in the office, a secretary, she goes, "You went to see the wife of the top leader in the neighborhood, and few people get to meet her, but you got to meet her." I kept going back probably every 2 months to see the Rebbitzin. She took a very special interest and became what I called a friend. She would ask me how I'm doing, all questions about how's work, you know, life, how's your mother? You go out and date? I said, yeah. Promise me you'll marry a nice Jewish girl.
Al bishase treft a yidn, i di reishe sin yoni baze iz a ziche, i das nid bederech mikre nikre uchas vishole, no dosi bash goche protis, dafer gleich onim zach misanin sein, efshir koner em helfen, beruchnis, oder begashmis, oder in beide in yoni. Wo dosi zach a zeder seder fun bal shem te von.
You know, I remember Mr. Schneerson once said to me, "If you ever need my help, doctor, I'll help you." I dated this young lady. Turned out her father got very sick. She called me up pretty sad, crying, said, "Could you please get a bracha from the Rebbe and call the Rebbitzin up to do that?" I said, "Sure, what's the matter? My father's very sick, he needs a surgery. We don't know the future." I said, "Okay, I'll make the call." I called Mr. Schneerson up and I said, "Look, I said, could you please do me a favor and ask your husband for a bracha?" And she says, "Get me the name of the gentleman and his mother's name, I'll pass it on." I said, "Fine." She goes, "Not to worry, all will be well."
We arrived in the United States in 1975, and we came to Crown Heights. And I worked for Mrs. Frieda Kugel for a very short time. She still has the business with her Vicks. One day, I answered the phone, and the lady on the other line was a Russian-speaking woman. She said, "Who are you? What is your name?" I said, "My name is Rita." "And where is Frieda?" I said, "She's not home. Can I take a message, please?" She said, "Yes, you will, but later. Tell me about yourself. Who are you? Where are you coming from?" Was it difficult to get out? And your family and parents and your siblings, you have plans for them to come. She was so caring.
I tut tevli brius, Sachen, was sie seinen gut für der zweite nicht mehr um sich. Durch Dru, was helft ihm ein Reis, durch Beweisen ihm ein lieblichen Pony und geben ihm ein nächster Tevel und sich noch fragen bei ihm, was macht er und was er geht, was bei ihm in der Mischproche und ausdrücken ihm alle gute Bruches und Wünschen, wo das geht noch mehr zu in dem Tevel, als schon mal ihm an der Ebenstelle geht ihm noch mehr Bruches.
I said, "Will you please introduce yourself, because I felt inside something unusual, you know." And she said, "This is Mrs. Schneerson." And I said, "Oh," I said, "I'm sorry." I said, "Maybe it was a little bit rude of me to give you such a direct question. I mean, who am I speaking with? But it's my honor and it's a great privilege talking to you." And I told her that my mother came to this country and she was diagnosed with a third stage cancer, and I have two small children and I have to go to work, and that's what I'm doing. The Rebbitzin asked me, "What hospital is your mother in? Do you think you need more help, assistance? What can I do for you? What can I do for your family?" I asked, to give a bracha to my mother and my children. And she said, "Send them to yeshiva and everything." I said, "Yes, yes." "And as far as your mother," she said, "everything will be all right." And she gave me a bracha. My mom lived another 24 years after that. 24 years after she was operated, diagnosed and operated of terminal cancer.
The girl's father had surgery. I inquired how he was doing. It turned out the surgery went quite well. He did quite well. He recovered very nicely from a serious operation. I called the Rebbetzin back. She goes, is he doing? He's doing well. I said, yes, he's doing very well. I want to thank you and thank your husband for the bracha. And she said, fine, I'll do that. Thank you for calling. And as I said, I told you all would be well.
She was a Yiddish mama, and that's what you felt with each word, each expression, the caring and the loving person.
Und late ihre Anweisungen und late ihre Beispiele.